Welcome to another exciting edition of Unhinged Music Reactions. And Doug, you know what I'm going to show you now?
Who?
Right.
Who are you going to show me?
That's correct. Okay. Anyway.
The failed abacus.
So The Who, my all-time favorite band, I've been a huge Who fan since I was a teenager. They just put out, they're about to put out a new album on December 6th. Now it's, of course, just the two remaining members, Roger Daltrey and Pete Townsend, but they put together a great band. They're touring. They have this new album called simply Who. And they have, no, don't go there. And they put out this single called Ball and Chain, which I've already heard, and I got to tell you, it sounds like The Who. There's no question about it that it's The Who.
Ball and Chain. For all you wives out there.
No, it's not about that.
Sorry.
So anyway, I'm excited to have you listen to Ball and Chain by The Who right after this. All right.
Who is this again?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
So this is The Who, Ball and Chain, brand new song from 2019.
Wow. It's the Partridge Family. I'm in tune.
Yeah.
I'm in tune.
So if you didn't know who this was and someone asked, who do you think this is?
I'd say, yes, exactly. No, it sounds a lot like that. It sounds very Tommy-ish.
Yeah, with a little Who's Next mixed in.
Yeah.
I mean, it's definitely got some bits and pieces from their past.
It sounds very fresh. I'm actually...
His voice is actually sounding pretty good. We'll talk about that. But let's listen some more.
When you light up in Cuba, you won't feel the same again.
Got a Bob O'Reilly feel too.
A little bit, that keyboard.
Still guilty with no charge.
break. Well, all I have to say is they're back. I mean, that's the Who. There's no question.
No, there isn't a question. If at first you thought maybe Roger Daltrey found another band to play with. No, it's clearly Pete Townsend.
Yeah.
He's got the signature acoustic with the signature probably a Fender Tellier Strat in the background. It had Bob O'Reilly elements that had...
It had a lot of...
I'm in tune.
Yeah, it's like, had some Who's Next stuff in there, and like going mobile a little bit. And those breaks were classic Townsend.
Then those chords he was doing when you mentioned it towards the end there, that was all those chords he loves to play.
Yeah.
And it's like they're playing because they want to play music, and let's take all the elements that are just... clearly Who, not even purposely, but just they work together to just fits like a glove.
It does. And you know, I've like I said before, I've been a Who fan for decades, and they put out an album several years ago called Endless Wire, and that was like supposed to be their big new album since, you know, they quote unquote broke up years ago. But it wasn't well received. Roger Daltrey's voice wasn't all there. He was struggling. He actually had, I don't know if there were polyps or something removed from his vocal cords, but they keep growing back. For this album, he did have surgery beforehand to remove some of those again. And he also just recently had surgery again during this tour to remove more of those growths. But it seems to work because they've released three singles so far from this new album, and they all sound like classic Who, just like this song, Ball and Chain. The other two, very classic Who. And his voice is top-notch. It hasn't sounded this good in a long time.
It sounds like him.
Yeah. I mean, he's got that tone. He's got that grit.
Yeah. No, it wouldn't be my favorite Who song, but it's basically like if you feel like listening to the Who, because you want to hear, because they have a very distinct sound and distinct
and
style. So if you want to hear the Who, you put this on and it's perfectly legit.
Yeah, no, absolutely. They're back in that sense that they're now creating brand new music that is classic Who. I mean, it's undeniably all of Townsend and all of Daltrey all in on this. And I love it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like you said, it's not going to be, my favorite Who song of all time. But it's grown on me tremendously in the few times I've listened to it in the last 2 days.
Yeah, so. and the players that they got, you know, the other players are just, they're complimenting Who music. And
yeah, the drummer.
As Kenny Jones did, and now Ringo's kid is doing.
Yep,
you know,
Zach Starkey.
I imagine he's probably better than Ringo because it's hard not to be. But Ringo has a distinctive sound. Obviously.
Oh, yeah.
But it's they're just, I mean, this is.
Yeah, they're touring. Who? They're touring with a bassist named John Button, who apparently is a session guy. He's played with a bunch of other bands in the past.
Ironically, he was on the Button there. I mean, as far as the style and what complements his guitar playing and everything.
And Simon Townsend is also on backup guitars and vocals.
And he's played with them for years.
Yeah.
Been affiliated with them for years.
Right. They've got a great band together and a great sound that they're continuing to put out. And they're in their 70s now. It's crazy.
The fact that they're playing and have a new album with new music that sounds good and that they're playing is enough. But then also the fact that, you know, Townsend is a very unique guy. And so is Daltrey, and the vastly different styles of living. They always did.
Yes.
So the fact that they're also getting along and playing music together this is a big thing.
Yeah, no, interestingly, when they collaborate musically, when they actually go to record, Townsend's never with Daltrey when he records the vocals. Roger wants to just be by himself. He's like, I'll do it. Leave me alone.
They'll probably never get to anything because there'd just be no, it isn't the end.
Right. But Pete has said in the past that, you know what, it works because, you know, he'll come back and listen to it and be like, wow, that's great.
We're way past that Daltrey's jogging while he's drinking a fifth. You know, it's like, it's way past.
Yeah.
So they just know they have
great
that
dynamic.
Magical conjunction.
Definitely. Yeah.
That's awesome. It's very encouraging.
It is. I was hoping to go see them when they came to Denver. They postponed, I think, because it might have been during his surgery time. But also the tickets were really expensive.
Yeah, so the scallops in his throat and everything.
I've seen them in the past already a few times, so I skipped this time. But now I'm kind of wishing I went.
Well, who knows what'll happen if they can come back and give them a call, see what happens.
Oh, I'll ring up Pete right after this.
Very cool. It's nice to know they're still around, and so. Yeah, get ready on December 6th. Pick up that.
I'm just glad that what Pete Townsend said years ago didn't happen, and that's hope he dies before he gets old, because we wouldn't have this new music coming out.
Did he write the lyrics? Did he always write the lyrics?
Yeah, he wrote all the music and lyrics for the most part.
Because Roger was always so much the focal, the band lead, you know, the front man.
He's the front man, yeah.
So you're thinking it's him saying it, but really,
yeah.
You know, it's pretty much Pete Townsend is the creator.
Oh, yeah. No, I mean, that's, absolutely. The others Roger's around him were interpreting his musical concepts, basically.
Yeah. Well, it's ironic, isn't it? Hope I die before I get old, and they're the only ones still around making new albums.
That's right.
It's amazing. It's encouraging.
It is. All right.
Good one.
All right. Subscribe, like, hit the bell, tell your friends.
Now. Do it.
All right. Until next time, rock and roll.